Right, moving on from Hapton. Beautiful sunny day. Let's see what the day brings. Hapton visitor moorings are opposite an industrial unit. They love playing music loud. It's peaceful at night though. Storage area. They wanted a waterside pitch for that one. So the road runs parallel to the canal here. And these are permanent moorings on the right hand side, so they've got constant traffic noise the whole time. Don't think I'd like that. Busy road, still lots of green murk all over the top of the canal. There's a bit of a bend in the canal here, quite a tight left hand bend. Round it, I can see it. Very disappointing, the canal, besides the thick duckweed, it's littered plastic. You can hear the boats labouring now because it's all round the prop. You have to stop, put it in reverse, try and clear it. see all the bits of debris that are laying on the top. Sea of green, sky of blue in my plodding narrow boat. The stonework they use to build houses here though. It's a canal and river trust. Putting rocks in the netting they used to line the banks with. See if I can get some water. Day have been so few of them this year. It's really warm. Lots of debris in the canal still. I think the duckweed suspends it. It manifests itself into clumps. What's it all on its own? Have you seen the parents?
Yeah, they're there.
Oh, they're there.
They're
oh,
okay. Just ignoring it.
Nature's cruel sometimes. Just a baby bird she's concerned about.
Well, what's wrong with it?
Parents are ignoring it. Humans do that too. That's it then, in the weed hatch. Nice pair of trousers, I think. I think I'll wash and iron them. The M62 we're going under after the escapade with the nice pair of black trousers I've just got from the weed hatch. Marks and Spencer's, eat your heart out. Into the tunnel. This one's a baby one. I can see the end and there's nothing coming. Well, as far as tunnels go, this is a nice easy one. It's double width, so you haven't got to worry about hitting the sides. The duckweed that grows so prolifically can't grow in here because it's dark. So that's really nice. There's nothing to clog the propeller and the rudder up. And all in all, nice easy one. We're coming to the end now. The daylight's getting bigger and bigger. And you can see all the green duckweed just just past the tunnel entrance that we're going to have to plod our way through again. Right, out into the daylight. So that was the Gano Tunnel, and it's one of the few tunnels, if not the only tunnel, that they allow you to kayak through. Personally, I wouldn't fancy kayaking through there. So this area we're going through now is called Whitfield. Lots of residential property. Okay. Here's a relic from the past, the steeple. There's modern housing built right up against this old mill. I would think that's probably a mill in its day. This is a really big aqueduct we're coming up to on the approach to Burnley town centre. Really nice little wooded area here. It never ceases to amaze me how canals give a totally different aspect to big towns and cities. It is a different world. Tight bend. I think the duckweed had clogged up the propeller. Again, I had not a lot of control over it and made a bit of a pig's ear of it. Anyway, it's all done, dusted now. We're on our way again. Well, it's a classic example of making good use of old wharf buildings. They look very attractive. There's some derelict ones over there on the left-hand side. Oh, there's some grand old wharf buildings here. Such a shame there's closed up, out of business. What a magnificent position that's got. Another one might die.
it's handy it's got them, isn't it?
Whole loading bay that's undercover, and it's got the original crane hoists. Fantastic old ironwork they used to do. This would have been a busy wharf back in the day. Now a forgotten corner, really. And that's the old toll house looking back the other way. So this is the inn on the wharf from the other side, the front elevation basically. And the canal's immediately behind it. Wonderful old brick stone they used to use. Shame the pub is closed, but there are some small office stroke industrial units here as well. Really nice though. Nice cobbled forecourt. Just see the horse and carts coming in here in the day gone by. Wow, some magnificent building here in Burnley. Sure what it is, I have to research it. It's dead opposite this nice selection of bedding plants. Very nice. Well, on the windows they're engraving saying town clerk, cashier. I suspect it's the town hall, or was. Back in the day, Burton's tailors used to have elaborate premises, and they were often on street corners, and they always had a snooker hall upstairs above them, and that would have been the snooker hall back in the day. But I'm talking like, you know, 60-70 years ago now. As a boy I can just remember one in Reading that had a snooker hall. There's a grand old pub. I'm always on about pubs, aren't I? Must be my misspent youth. And there's one up there called the Boot Inn. That's another nice building, nice brick stonework on it. There's an old fashioned Sharabang advert. Used to see them all over the place once time. Well, the Boot Inn is a Wetherspoons, so it's got to be done.